Time for the Coen Brothers tier list. Official. Okay, I haven't seen every single Coen Brothers movie, but I've seen quite a few. All right, let me frame this nicely here. Okay, I'm ready. Coen Brothers tier list. Okay, so I put the movies that I haven't seen at the very bottom here. I have not seen Lady Killers. I've not seen The Hudsucker Proxy. I've not seen The Man Who Wasn't There. And I have not seen this movie. I don't know what it is. Intolerable Cruelty. I have not seen Intolerable Cruelty. But I'm pretty sure I've seen every single other movie here. So, first, Barton Fink. I think Barton Fink is great. Like I was saying earlier, it has such such a clear character who wants something very distinctly, and the world around them is such a mess that it heightens the drama, and it's hilarious. It is a great movie. Two amazing performances by John Turturro and John Goodman. But normally I would put this movie very high on a tier list, but because it is the Coen Brothers, there are so many that I do think might be a little better. So I think this is a good baseline of a nice B tier. Barton Fink A? I'm tempted. It is great. Is it mid tier? Let me look at the other films here. Okay, you know what? A. Yeah, not S. Oh no, I just pressed NHL.com. All right, Barton Fink, A tier. Big Lebowski. I'm gonna be honest, when I saw Big Lebowski first time, I was a little underwhelmed because I don't think I knew what I was getting into. But going into it again, it's so good. And I'm a bowler myself. I appreciate the representation of bowlers. Big Lebowski has achieved cult status on a massive scale, and it has its own religion. It does have its own religion. Okay, personally, I don't know if I put it in S tier. I definitely see A. I haven't seen this movie in about 4 or 5 years. 4 or 5 years since I've seen Big Lebowski. I should rewatch it. I'm gonna put it in A. A for now. A for now. I agree. It is a cult classic for a reason. Okay. Moving on to the next one. Okay, I see a lot of Big Lebowski fans. I understand. I think I just haven't seen in a long time. It is amazing. Okay, Miller's Crossing. I think this is the baseline. Miller's Crossing is baseline. Like, it's good drama. I love the scene where he's going out into the forest and he's gonna kill him, but then he's pleading with him. And it's like, there's so many times with he's pleading with him not to kill him. John Turturro carries this movie. Main guy is good. He's kind of the more stoic guy. But I do love the vibe of this. It's such like a small scale crime movie that would be like a film kid's dream to make, like right fresh out of university. Like, it's such a classic crime tale. I'm going to put Miller's Crossing in B. Yeah, Miller's Crossing B. I agree. All right. Next one, Raising Arizona. I think there's no question about where I'm putting Raising Arizona. Just spent the last hour talking about it. Raising Arizona is undoubtedly an S tier. Undoubtedly. D? Okay, are you saying that seriously? Or are you just yanking my chain? Because, yeah, nothing's going to dethrone Raising Arizona in my eyes. F? Okay, yeah. It's a B movie, but compared to the rest of the Coens, it's C. Ooh, okay. I spent this whole 2 hours talking about how I love Raising Arizona, and now I'm getting some Raising Arizona slander. Please explain. Elaborate. Okay, Night of... Wait, what movie are you talking about? With John Turturro. Am I stupid? What's a John Turturro movies? Best John Turturro movie of all time is undoubtedly Transformers. We all know this. Oh, it's a show. Oh, okay. Oh, you're just yoinking my chain. Okay, got it. Okay, I do need to rewatch Big Lebowski. I agree. Okay. Owen. Whew. Okay, you're referring to Miller's Crossing. Good. Not Raising Arizona. Okay, I'm sorry. I had a little bit of an outburst about Raising Arizona slander. Get a bit defensive, I'll admit. Oh, one other thing I want to mention about Big Lebowski. Did you guys know there was like a sequel called The Jesus Rolls? I started watching it because I was like, oh, bowling movie, crime movie, sounds cool. It's so bad. It's really bad. I didn't finish it. But it was made in 2019 and it stars John Turturro as his role of Jesus. It's really bad. It's really, really bad. It's really sexual. Like, these two guys, like, find this woman and they're just, like, hanging out and having sex. It's a weird movie. Very weird. Ugh, I wanted it to be good because a bowling crime. Maybe that's my calling, to make a bowling-centered crime movie. I think that would be sick. You just don't think he's a good actor. Mm. Oh, John directed it. Oh. Yeah, the Jesus Rolls. Yeah, he did direct. Of course he directed it. That's so funny. Oof. It was made for $4.5 million and it made $64,000 at the box office. Ooh. That's not very good. Yeah, don't watch it. Don't watch it. I would not recommend it to anybody. Even though it has all the elements of a movie that I think I would like, but no way. All right, I'm just going to throw in another classic Raising Arizona tune here real quick. Where is that one I wanted? All right. This is the music at the very end. Okay. Next movie. The Ballad of Buster Scruggs. I really like The Ballad of Buster Scruggs. I really do. I think, is it the only anthology here? Yeah. Only anthology here, which, I mean, yeah, I guess anthologies aren't as common, but I think The Ballad of Buster Scruggs have some really high highs, but skits that are low are a little, like, super. But the one scene with, who is it? Is it Tom Waits? The one where he finds gold. What is it? Ballad of Buster Scruggs, the Gold Miner. Who is that? Is that Tom Waits? Buster Scruggs. Okay, I see. Ballad of Buster Scruggs C, I might agree with that, actually. I do agree with it, but I think there's a couple of them, a couple of the skits that are really, really good. Let's see here. Okay, this IMDb page is helping me with that. Okay, Buster Scruggs. What are the skits again? Let me try to remember. We got the first one, which is just Buster Scruggs. That one's fun. It's a good intro, musical. The one with James Franco, top tier. First time. That one's great. That one's classic Coen's. Like, the story is like him constantly going to get hung, and then you got the sniper shooting him out every single time so they can escape. That one's great. Then you got the gold miner one, my favorite one, because it's like, it's literally just about him mining gold, and then somebody comes and tries to take it from him. Not much to say. The drama built into it. Then the other ones, like, the one in the stagecoach is not that great. And the one at, like, the fair with the head. I think it started off, it had a nice curve. It started off nice, got to some highs, and then it kind of just plummeted. Am I forgetting one? Was there just five? I might have even been more. But I think it is fun, but I think there's the high highs, there's the low lows. I'm going to put it in B. Okay. Next one. Give me 1 second. Let me set the mood. Raising Arizona soundtrack. Let me put this back on. Okay. This is the introduction, A Hole in the Ground. That's what it's called. Okay. Next one is A Serious Man. Top tier. S tier. A Serious Man is so good. I watched it, I think, just over a year ago, and I think it is incredible. Like, who's that main actor again? I'm trying to remember his name. Serious Man. Michael Stuhlbarg. Yeah, I love Michael Stuhlbarg. He's incredible. And I think that him just... Yeah, the movie is... I'm trying to remember. It's been a while. He's trying to figure out his life. He realizes he has some... He might have a heart condition. He keeps trying to go to the doctor, and at the end he tells him he actually does have, like, this condition. But then there's the tornado at that. I remember that ending. That ending's great with the tornado. But A Serious Man is top tier. Now, I don't know if I'm bold enough to say S. I think it's my third favorite, and I'm putting it in S. Below Raising Arizona. I love A Serious Man. Just, like, he's the most mundane guy, and these these crazy things happen to him. It's... Highly recommend. Highly recommend A Serious Man. Blood Simple. They are first feature. It's good. It's a good crime movie. A good start to their career. Low budget. I think $1.5 million. But it's their first one for a reason. And I gotta say, it's probably... Looking at these other films here, bottom two out of the ones I've seen. So if I'm trying to spread them out nicely, I'm putting it in a D. Unfortunately, it is... Okay, every single one of their movies I like. I'll say that. Every single one of the movies that I like. You know, to balance it more, I'm putting Buster Scruggs in C. Because looking at the other ones, there's just so many ones that are better. But yeah, Blood Simple. It's good. Not great. Okay, Burn After Reading. Actually... This might have been the first one I ever watched. And I remember really, really liking it. I do not remember the plot too well. But I do remember thinking, wow, this movie is crazy. And that makes sense if it was my first one, because I hadn't known the Coens before, and I see Burn After Reading it, and I'm like, this is a crazy movie. The scene where he gets... That's crazy. I'm trying to remember what happens in this movie. I'm gonna look up a plot real quick. Burn After Reading plot. Here we go. When a disc containing memoirs of a former CIA analyst, John Malkovich, falls into the hands of Linda Litsky, Francis McDormand, and Chad Brad Pitt, the two gym employees see a chance to make enough money. Oh, okay, right. Yeah. This is just one of their plots it's such a twisting plot, and it's just... Yeah, I think B is quite fair for this. I think B is quite fair. Yeah, I'm sorry for the Blood Simple slander. I hadn't seen it in a very long time, but, like, they grew as filmmakers because of Blood Simple, and I do think it's great. Every single movie on this is a great movie, but in their entire filmography, I gotta put it lower. But yeah, Burn After Reading is a B. I think it's better than these two at the bottom here. Probably on the same level as Miller's Crossing. I do love Burn After Reading. Okay, Fargo. Perhaps one of their most known, most beloved, Fargo. And I watched Fargo a long time ago as well. And there's a few distinct scenes I have burned into my memory. The wood chipper, one of them. Francis McDormand's accent. And, yeah. Okay, Fargo, this is their... Okay, Raising Arizona, such a distinct style in the heat of the desert. This is just opposite that. And a little more serious, but still, they have... You got the accents, you got everything. Yeah, it's going in S tier. Fargo, S tier. I feel like I'm gonna put too many of these next ones in S tier. I gotta balance it out a little. I think right now it would be go Raising Arizona, Fargo, Serious Man. For me, I would put Barton Fink, Big Lebowski, and The Crossing Burden. Yeah, okay, so the top ones are on the left, and then it goes to the right. What is this song? What scene is this from? Just Business. I'm gonna skip this one. Okay. Hail Caesar. Hail Caesar's actually good. I'll say it's actually good. But it's not up to the level as every other film by them. I think this is bottom tier, but it is good. It's about Hollywood. I'm trying to remember. All I remember is Scarlett Johansson. She's an actress. She comes out of the water in that one scene. I do remember really liking it. But in the grand filmography of the Coens, I probably have to put it in D, because it's probably... Man, this is tough. Because now I'm thinking Hail Caesar or Buster Scruggs. What do I like better? And I don't know, because there are some lows in Buster Scruggs, and Hail Caesar left me with a very happy feeling. I did like Hail Caesar quite a bit. But I feel bad having Blood Simple just in D tier by itself. Okay, doing a little rearranging. This is how it's gonna go. Balance things out. Is that too drastic? Then we can fit some of these top tier ones in the top. Is this too drastic? Okay, I'm gonna leave it like this for now. Should I do some more? Okay, I'm balancing a little more. There. This is the balance I'm going for right now. Buster Scruggs, I know. Everything in the Okay, balanced it. It's final. This is what I'm leaving it as. Okay, Inside Llewyn Davis. I'm looking at this and doubting myself so much. Okay, we have to remember every single movie here is good. By D, it means like A by regular film standards. If any of these movies came out this year, they would be in the top three. Any of these movies would be in my top three of the year. Okay, Inside Llewyn Davis, one of my good friends, one of his top films of all time. I haven't seen it in a long time. I gotta say, I am putting Llewyn Davis, A to S range, 100%. This is another film where you're like, it's crazy that they made Llewyn Davis and Raising Arizona, the same filmmakers. A much more serious, brooding Oscar Isaac performance as the lovable guitarist and folk singer. It's him refusing to change to what society wants him to be. Which honestly, yeah, that's a lot of movies here. Barton Fink, similarly. Am I bold enough to put an S? Yes, I am. Bottom of S here. I'm gonna turn down the music a little. Okay. No Country for Old Men. Undoubtedly an S tier. An S tier if I've ever seen one. Their second best movie. And I think a lot of people know this. Let me just double check my facts here. No Country for Old Men. Winning Best Picture. Yeah, just wanted to make sure I wasn't remembering incorrectly. It also won Best Performance by an Actor in a Supporting Role. Javier Bardem. Best Direction. Best Writing, and it was nominated for Cinematography, Editing, Sound Mixing, and Sound Editing. Nominated for all the technical ones, won a lot of the creative ones. And yeah, it's a critic darling. Won Best Picture. And I love it. It's so, like, every single scene. Even if it's a slow scene instead of a chase, like, you're interested in every single detail. I think I've seen this movie 3 times. The first movie, my mind was blown. Second movie, I went back to it, and I'm like, does it hold up? Yes, it holds up. it holds up very much. And the ending scene where he's in the pool, it's just such a stark contrast to the whole movie, and it feels like such a letdown, but it works so well. Ugh. If you haven't seen No Country for Old Men, that is the one movie on this whole list I'd say go watch. All right, No Country for Old Men, undoubtedly an S tier. Oh Brother, Where Art Thou? I remember hearing about this movie and being like, this is the coolest aesthetic I've ever seen. These folk singers, prisoners, it was awesome. The feeling is awesome. I don't know if they stick the landing. As in, it is incredible. It is very, very amazing. The atmosphere is great. I think the story, not as iconic, as clear and concise as some other ones. But, man, best music. Based on the Odyssey. Oh, I didn't know that. Okay. But yes, I do love Oh Brother, Where Art Thou. I think I'm putting it, I think B tier. Don't want to put it with A tier. No. B tier. I'm putting this in B tier. Top of B tier. Okay, Serious Man kind of is just sitting there by itself. How do I balance this? Do I keep these four at S tier? Oh, I think I have to. And I will move... Pardon me. Okay. Last one that I've seen. I have not seen these last four. Last one that I've seen, True Grit. A remake of an old movie. I watched this one the most recently besides Raising Arizona, of course. And I gotta say, I watched it with my brother. It is incredible. I am a Western man. As in, I am a very big fan of Westerns, especially modern Westerns. And I will put this at the tippy top of B tier. Tippy top of B tier. No Country for Old Men is another modern Western that does it perfectly. This is one that is more palatable, sticks the landing, it's incredible. I do love True Grit. And this is it. I think this is my tier list. Oof. I think the most divisive one was Big Lebowski. People love their Big Lebowski. They love the dude. And I do too, but I haven't seen it in a very long time. And I don't remember... When I walked out of the theater, I don't remember the feeling that I had very much. So, I'm leaving it in B tier. This is my tier list. The Coen brothers. But let me say, on... My ratings on Letterboxd of all these movies, I don't think any of them are below a 3-star. I think Blood Simple and Hail Caesar are probably both 3 stars. And everything else is 3.5 and above. Like, the Coens are masters. I said it many times, even in my essay. The Coens know how to make movies. And yeah, man, their filmography is incredible. I love the Coens. Blood Simple at D is a travesty. I'm sorry, Owen. I'm very sorry. I haven't seen Blood Simple in a long time. Yeah, Blood Simple and Lebowski are the most divisive. But I'm pretty happy with this. I'm going to leave it at this right now. This is me, my personal ranking. And we all know that, every one of these movies is pretty freaking incredible. Praising Arizona. You know what? That's true. It is called Praising Arizona. I do love Raising Arizona so much. And I think I do have a bit of nostalgia goggles on when I'm talking about Raising Arizona. I will admit that. But, hey. I love Raising Arizona. I have my Hawaiian shirt here. And I like to think that I got my Hawaiian shirt wearing habits from H.I. McDonough. Good ol'. H.I. McDonough. Let me bring that back up. Where is it? Oh, did I close it? Give me 1 second. If you weren't here earlier. We got this, Oh, no. My kidnapping habits, oh, don't worry about it. Okay, you see, they play off kidnapping, so, like, not a big deal in Raising Arizona. Gonna have some bad influences on some people. No, I'm just kidding. Sorry, I'm trying to pull this back up here. I'm curious, what's everyone else's favorite Coen Brothers movie? Mine, clearly, Raising Arizona, followed shortly by No Country for Old Men. I'm curious what everyone else's is. That's what he does in the country. Oh, yeah. Oof. What do we got? Lady Killers underrated. Maybe I should watch that. Maybe that's my next watch. As I say, as a film kid. I'm gonna watch that later. Yeah, right. Yeah, right you are.